Today, we are going to teach you a very cool method for making videos. Why is this type of video so cool? The key is that the elements in the video do not move and change according to our conventional ideas. You have no way of predicting which direction it will develop in the next second. This uses a technology called ATI, which stands for Trajectory Guided Animation. This technology originally came from ByteDance. We can draw trajectories of any form on the screen, and the model will change the corresponding object based on the trajectory we draw. Moreover, there are no restrictions on the drawing of this trajectory. Not long after this model was released, it was implemented as an extension on WanVideo. We have actually provided corresponding tutorials before, but maybe the impression wasn't that deep. The reason is that drawing the trajectory in previous videos was not very convenient, so the cost of generating the video was relatively high. Now the situation is completely different. In the ComfyUI extension, a new node is provided. This node can help us draw the corresponding trajectory very easily, which makes the implementation of the entire ATI animation very simple. How exactly do we achieve this? Let's analyze it step by step. I have also built the workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform through runninghub.ai in the field of ComfyUI. Running Hub is an excellent online working platform. This is because as long as new models and extensions appear, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in the video description. This way, you can receive 1,000 free credits. In addition, logging into Running Hub every day will also give you 100 bonus points. This allows you to try out your own workflows. Before using this workflow, we first need to install the extension. The name of this extension is ComfyUI Fill Nodes. The installation method is very simple. You just need to clone it into your custom node folder and install the required dependencies. Okay, now let's look at the workflow. First, there is the loading of the main model. The main model we are currently using is the ATI model based on WAN 2.1. And it is an image-to-video model. This model can be downloaded from Kijai's Hugging Face repository. Then we need to load an acceleration LoRA. We are using CosVid here, not the commonly used Light X2V. This can also be downloaded from Kijai's Hugging Face repository. We then use Sage Attention. The shift value is set to 5.0, the WAN 2.1 encoder, and its VAE remain unchanged. Note that the author of this extension has collected all these models and placed them in a Boolean repository. You can see that we can get CosVid, our ATI model, the encoder, and the VAE here. So, if you find it troublesome to search for each model individually from Kijai's repository, you can download them directly from here. I have a reference image. It has very rich background information, a youthful and beautiful girl standing in a cherry blossom forest, with a tall tower behind her and both green belts and cherry blossom trees nearby. Therefore, when creating background animation, there will be more movable elements. Next, we reset the size. I set the resolution to 720 by 1024. Then comes the prompt section. To keep it simple, I used QWBWell to automatically generate the prompt. I also set the max tokens to 128, so the generated prompt won't be too long. I selected the preset prompt style here, of course. You can write the prompt yourself if you prefer. Now we come to the most crucial part, how to use trajectory to guide video generation. First, we take the reference image. I need to repeat it for 81 frames because I want to generate an 81 frame animation. Then it passes through the most important node here, which is called Path Animator. It actually helps us draw this path. This path will be stored in the form of JSON. You will find that this content is very extensive and we cannot write it out manually. After processing through this node, we will get a set of images. If you use a mask, there will be a mask. In addition, we get the coordinates corresponding to the trajectory. We need to connect the width, height, and frame length based on the situation of our current reference image. Next, let me explain in detail how to draw this trajectory. There is a very important button here called Edit Path. We can click it open. Note that there is a canvas here, which is a completely new editing page. Therefore, we need to save this image here. Let's click it. First, we delete all the paths that have already been drawn. The way to delete them is to select a trash can here called Clear All Path. We click this directly to delete them. Notice that all paths are now gone. Next, we import an image. This is our reference image from before. Now let's talk about the specific usage. This is for clearing the background. These two are opposites. One adds the background and the other clears the background. This one is actually used for drawing the path. You can draw the path like this. Then you can set its width here. Through background opacity, you can set the transparency of the background. Of course, this setting is only to help you draw the trajectory more clearly, and it will not have any effect on the final generated result. we can draw more trajectories. You can draw the trajectory freely according to your own ideas. There is another tool called Add Fixed Point. If you think there's some points in the image that should not change, you can select them using this tool. For example, I believe the point should not change or move. This is the deletion tool. The things you have drawn can be deleted individually using this tool. You can also delete them using the Clear All Path button. This is for selection. You can edit a specific point. You can check its state, whether it is linear interpolation or fade in and fade out. This will affect the movement speed of the final animation. This tool mainly locks the edges of the image. It will generate 12 points. When I click now, it asks if you want to use 12 points to lock the outer frame. If we click confirm, you will find that there are 12 points on the side. Once this edge is locked, camera movement will not occur. These are the uses of the various tools. Next, let's simply draw some paths. We will delete everything first. First, we lock the scene with these 12 points. Then we set the points that should not move. I think the head and shoulders should not move. I will draw a few simple ones. Then we draw the points that should move. We select the brush tool. For example, I think the grass should move down and the tree moves up, which is the opposite. And the grass on this side moves up and the tree moves down. We want the tower to move down. I'll just draw a few for the cherry blossoms above. Now we have drawn a few paths. If you want to edit the movement change method of each path, we can use the selection tool to select a specific path. You should notice that this one is currently linear. I'll choose ease in here. For this one, I'll choose ease out, and this one, I'll choose ease in out. After this, we have the path. Now we click save. This path is then stored in the JSON data, of course. If we look at this data now, it might not be very clear. The main purpose is to use this visual editing method to help us generate such data. Moving down, there is a visualization of the trajectory. This is displayed through the node shown in our video. You can see how each trajectory moves. They are currently all linear, so you will find that every speed is the same, but the ones I drew just now are not all linear. Further down is the sampling section. Note that we will now use a node called WanTrackToVideo. This is an official ComfyUI node. Here we input the positive prompt, negative prompt, Virginia E, our reference image, and our clip vision output. How is this obtained here? We use the commonly used visual encoder. This model can be found in ComfyUI's official Hugging Face repository. You need to pay attention. It is within the WAN 2.1 model. We can see the split files. Inside there is a file called clip version. This is the model. Its size is 1.26 gigabytes. Then, after our sampling, note that this sampler is also a special sampler provided by our fill node extension. Since we used an acceleration model, this is an 8-step sampling. The CFG is 1.0, the sampler is UniPC, and the scheduler is simple. Other settings can basically remain at default. Next, we will regenerate a video according to the new trajectory we marked. Note that these three points are static. These are the three static points we just locked. In addition, the 12 points on the edge are static. Furthermore, the movement speed of each trajectory inside is different because we set different movement methods. There is linear movement and fade out movement. Now the sampling has begun. Let's wait a moment. Okay, everyone, take a look. This is the final generated video. The three points we pinned are static. The skirt has a basic sway, and pay attention. The direction of movement of the grass and the cherry blossom trees that we set, including their movement method and speed, are also different. Now, we notice that the tower doesn't seem to be moving. Therefore, when many motion effects are superimposed, some effects may not be realized overall. The effect of this trajectory-guided animation method is very obvious, and the animation feeling is very cool. Everyone can try it out yourself. Okay, that is all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.